Hey guys, and welcome to Knitgrid. Today we're going to go over how to make these really cute knit yoga socks. And they're super easy, they're great for working out, and they're just a nice little heelless sock that you can do whatever in. Even just wearing them around the house if you're chilly but want to have your feet touch on the ground. Alright, let's get started. For this project you will need worsted weight yarn. Today we're not using worsted weight yarn, we're using Brené Softy Baby, but I really liked how this colorway worked. Usually I would say definitely go with a size 4 or worsted weight. This is a size 3, so I'm going to get a looser stitch on this project here, which I'm okay with because when I wash it, it should actually come out just fine. So I'm going to make mine a little bit bigger than what my foot actually is so that when I wash it, it'll make up for the fact that I'm using a size 3 yarn. Alright, you're also going to need size 6 double pointed knitting needles, or I'm actually using these really cute size 6 12 inch round circular knitting needles because that's what I actually prefer, and I find that they're easier to go and work in the round when I actually have circular knitting needles. I bought these on Amazon. I'll have a link down in the description below in case you're interested in seeing anything about these. Alright, let's get started. To start, you're going to want to cast on. So how you cast on, this is a fully customizable pattern. So the way that this works is it's fully customizable to your foot and your foot alone. You're going to want to cast on 8 stitches for every inch around your widest part of your foot is. So for me, that's right underneath my toes is where the widest part is, which I imagine is for everyone. So I cast on, and that is 7 inches around. So I cast on 56 stitches because it was that long. So once you get your cast on, you're going to want to do a 2x2 rib. So you're going to purl 2 and you're going to knit 2. First, starting at, additionally, it doesn't really matter what you start out with, but I knit 2 and I purl 2. I don't know why I reversed that. Anyway, you're going to do that for about an inch. For me, that was 8 rounds because, well, that's about an inch for my gauge. And next, you're going to want to knit until you reach the top of your heel. So this will be about the inch above your ankle bone, like right above your ankle bone, and then you're going to knit from the top of your ankle bone down to the top of your, the top of your ankle bone down to the top of your heel. And you're just going to knit all the way down, and I'll show you what to do once you're done with all that. So now that you've reached the length that you want your heel to be, this should be right above where you want your heel opening to be, you're going to now take your stitches and divide them in half, essentially. So we're going to knit up to the halfway point here, and then we're going to cast off the other half. So for me, I cast on 56 stitches, so I'm going to knit 28, and I'm going to cast off 28, and I'll show you what to do once that's done. When you're done, you should have something that looks like this. Now, next, we're going to knit all 28 of these stitches, and then we're going to cast on 28 fresh new stitches. And I'll show you what to do once you've cast on. So once you get your cast on going on here, you're going to start to knit inside of your live stitches that have been live this entire time and turning it back into working in the round. We're gonna work in the round for about, we're gonna work in the round until we've reached an inch of what we want our arch length to be. So we're gonna knit until we get about an inch from there, and then we're gonna turn that into a 2x2 ribbing, and I'll show you when I get. Alright, so now that you have finished turning your heel and doing the arch of your foot part of this, and I cast off after doing about 8 rows of knitting, I now do something a little extra that you don't have to. If you're fine with how this heel looks, then you're done. That's all there is to it, but I like to actually go over this and make it a little bit more refined. I do that by crocheting around it, and I know that's because I'm multi-craftual and not many people know how to also knit and crochet at the same time. Usually they're in one camp or another, but I decided to just crochet around it because it's really easy, quick, and fast, and it gives it a nice little edge here. You could also foreseeably take the stitches here and do an I-cord bind off, which would be really cool as well. I might do that on my next pair. But for right now, I just did a little crochet around so that all the edges here and everything would look all tied together and nice. Some people don't like how crochet and knit look together. I like it, so that's what I ended up doing. And all I did was pick up the stitches starting over here, and then I went over so that this edge wouldn't have a nice weird slip stitch on it. I went up here, and then I skipped a stitch and finished it off there. I single crocheted all the way around the entire part and called it good. Alright, and once you've done your heels in whatever fashion you choose, you're all done, and you have these really cute knit yoga socks. And don't forget, we do have a crocheted version of this pattern, so if you're a bit more of a crocheter, then we have those available as well. Be sure to hit like and subscribe to our channel if you would like to see more videos like this. And until next time, guys!